Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use GitHub Copilot for absolutely free in Visual Studio Code. So Microsoft has recently announced GitHub Copilot is now free for Visual Studio Code. So first thing is just Google GitHub Copilot, you will be getting the first link. Click that and here you can see the AI editor for everyone and already have Visual Studio Code open now. So first thing is, basically you must have Visual Studio Code already installed on your system and just click on this Open Now option and click on Open Visual Studio Code and just click on Install Extension and Open URI. So it's basically installing the GitHub Copilot extension. So this is not an entirely free plan because they have the plans on pricing. So if you go here, the free plan comes with 2000 completions and 50 chat requests per month. And if you want to get upgraded, you can just do that. But the free version is also good for coding, you know. So again, go to Visual Studio Code and you need to sign in with your GitHub account now. So after entering your email and password for your GitHub, you'll be automatically directed to Visual Studio Code again. And here you'll be having the sign in option over there. If you click on sign in there, you'll be automatically getting this Ask Copilot chat feature. So if you want to see more shortcuts and commands for this, again just go to Google and if you search GitHub Copilot, this time the second link, GitHub Copilot overview. If you click that, and here you'll be having the installation and keyboard shortcuts. So let's see how we can use them now. I will just close this. And if I go to extensions, here you can see it has installed this GitHub Copilot as well as GitHub Copilot chat. And also to the top, you'll be having an icon like this. So if you click this, it will automatically open the chat. So first let me go and edit my existing code. For example, if I go to this option, this is Copilot edits, which is basically used to edit the existing code. So I'm having here a Node.js code, which is new.js, a simple JavaScript file where I have written simple API calls like this. So I'll just go here and as you can see, it automatically detects the files. So I can just close this or add a file. If you click on add files, basically you can add all the files that you have inside your folder. So I'll just go with my JavaScript file and here you can ask any questions or basically add corrections to this file. And the two models that are going to be used over here, one is GPT-4o and another one is Claude 3.5. So you can switch around with these models. I will go with GPT-4o and let me just give it a prompt. So I'm going with the prompt, can you please add the post and update API endpoints, because in my code I'm only having it for get. So if I run it, so it's basically now scanning and automatically generating the code inside my Visual Studio Code live. So here you can see it has added 27 lines and let me just minimize this and close this. So these are the new code which has been added. It has added the update one as well as the post one. So if you want this, you can accept this. If you don't want this code, you can just discard this. So I want to accept this, so I'll just click on accept and that's it, that code gets added over here. So if you don't like this, if you feel I don't like this code anymore, you can just do control Z, just undo that code and that code goes off. And let's see another cool feature of this GitHub Copilot, which is automatic IntelliSense. For example, now I am having the post and update operation, right? So I'll just go here and add a delete operation. So I'll just go here, app.delete, and here you can see it automatically gives me literally the entire code itself. So I'm just going to type delete, and in some cases you need to type more, like at least the name of the function as well as the parameters. Once you do that, it will automatically give you the content inside that function. So just by defining the function, you can create an entire function. So here also, you're having two options, accept word or accept the entire thing. That could be done by pressing the tab button. So if I just press the tab key, here you can see that entire code has been added over here. So that's really amazing and you can just, you know, correct this code and do anything with that. So that's the IntelliSense feature. So what if you wanted to edit this particular piece of code? In that case, you will just highlight the code which you want to edit and you're pressing the keys Control and I. So you'll be getting the Ask Copilot and this particular question that you're going to ask or any edit suggestion will be applied to only the code which you have highlighted or selected. So let me just go and ask, can you please change the table name to user. All right. And if I just send it, so it's thinking now. And as you can see here, it has basically changed the name, and you can see it has been highlighted. The change has been highlighted, and you can just click on accept. So this feature is for editing and particular text, and you can even go through the shortcuts. There are so many shortcuts available. So these methods are fine for editing the existing code in your file. And what if you wanted to create a new file or a project itself? You can also do that. So for that, just go to this chat feature. You can literally ask it to create a new project, like an application itself or an idea. It will literally create the files for you. So I'll just go with a simple one. So I am asking it to create a new file named main.py, the REST API code, and I'll just send it. And it's asking me to create a file. So I'll click on create file, and it has even automatically selected the location of my folder and given me the file name. That's amazing. And I'll just click on save file. So that's it. This entire code has been created within a flash. I'm having a main.py, Flask is there. I'm having the get data and post data route. So that literally took, you know, 1 second to create. And of course, you need to manually install the Flask over here. You need to install that. So that's basically it. If you want to know more, you can just, you know, see the documentation and know more about the features that they are having over here. Such an amazing feature, and really big thanks to Microsoft for giving this feature free. So that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in AI tools, programming, Gemini AI, OpenAI APIs. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.